Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to introduce to you an ancient place in Turkey, so stay tuned. Sancta Sapientia, commonly referred to as Hagia Sophia Grand Mosque, is a former church in Istanbul city which is considered a major cultural and historical landmark that dates back to 6th century AD, and its design has been emulated in constructing churches in other parts of the world as well. The current structure with 200,000 square feet of floor space was built by the Byzantine Empire, Justinian I, as the Christian Cathedral of Constantinople between 532 and 537 AD, and was designed by Greek architects. It was formerly called the Church of God's Holy Wisdom, and upon completion became the world's largest church with interior space that employed a fully pedantic dome. It is renowned as the pinnacle of Byzantine design and credited with altering the course of architectural history. The present Justinian building was the third church with the same name to occupy this site, as the prior ones had been destroyed throughout tumultuous epochs. For close to a millennium, it stood as one of the largest cathedrals globally until 1520. In 1204, during the Fourth Crusade, it was converted into a Catholic cathedral under the Latin Empire, and then it was reverted to the Eastern Orthodox Church upon the restoration of the Byzantine Empire in 1261. After the fall of Constantinople to the Ottoman Empire in 1453, it was converted to the principal mosque of Istanbul by Mehmed the Conqueror. This transition entitled the replacement of Christian artifacts, including bells, altars and baptistries, in addition to the mosaic depictions, with Islamic architectural elements such as four minarets, minbar, mihrab and Quran verses. The complex remained a mosque until 1931, when it was closed to the public for 4 years and repurposed in 1935 as a museum under the Secular Republic of Turkey. Throughout this time, it stood as Turkey's premier tourist attraction, a status it retained as of 2019. The main materials used in Hagia Sophia Mosque include brick, marble and mortar. Sand and ceramic pieces are the components of the mortar that distributed evenly. This combination was often used in Roman concrete, an antecedent to modern formulations. The nave is covered by central dome, soaring to a maximum height of 182 feet from floor level, and rests on an arcade of 40 arched windows. Repairs to its structure have rendered the dome somewhat elliptical, with a diameter of 102 feet. At the western entrance and eastern liturgical side, there are arched openings extended to the central part of the church. These structures are supported by exedrae, which are a hierarchy of circular form elements built up to create a vast oblong interior crowned by the giant dome with a span of 250 feet. The upper gallery is horseshoe-shaped that encloses the nave on three sides. This section traditionally has been reserved for the Empress and her court. There are several mosaic decorations in this part, the best preserved ones located in the southern part of the metronium. The central dome is built on four triangular pedantives, making the Hagia Sophia one of the first places that this element has been utilized in its design. The colossal dome at this edifice is 2 feet thick. The interior side of this part is adorned with Quran verses. The minarets, with 197 feet in height, were final additions during Ottoman epoch, deviating from the original Byzantine design of the church. One of the minarets in southeast was built from red brick and can be dated back to the reign of Mehmed or his successor Bayezid II. The other three minarets were built from white limestone and sandstone, of which the slender northeast one was erected at the behest of Bayezid II, and two identical larger minarets to the west side were constructed under Selim II and designed by the esteemed Ottoman architect Mimar Sinan. Initially during Justinian reign, the interior decorations comprised abstract designs on marble slabs, walls and floors. Subsequently, during the latter half of the 9th century, figurative embellishments were introduced, featuring depictions of Christ, saints, prophets, church fathers, historical figures associated with the cathedral, scenes from the Gospels in the galleries, and a monumental six-winged seraph angel adorning the corners of the central dome. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comments section, and if you would like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.